Kevin Spacey's Let Me Be Frank video.
It reminds me of lyrics from a song. I think the song starts like straight from the underground. A crazy motherfucker named someone. So yeah.
Straight out of Compton, crazy motherfucker named Ice Cube. From the gang called Niggas With Attitudes. When I'm called off, I got a sawed off. Squeeze the trigger and bodies are hauled off. You too, boy, if you fuck with me. The police are gonna have to come and get me off your ass. That's how I'm going out. For the punk motherfuckers that's showing out. Niggas start to mumble, they wanna rumble. Mix them and cook them in a pot like gumbo.
He seems to have lost his marbles, or quite a lot of them. I mean, sort of entering this weird, I mean, you can sort of expect artists to be slightly crazy. The problem is that when you combine it with sexual assault, it's not quirky
it's
anymore.
Not crazy.
No, it's not. I mean, it's sort of in this Michael Jackson-esque weirdness that he's entering into.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's. I watched the video first time, I think, about a month ago.
Yeah.
And now I watched it a second time, and definitely the second time was even
I
weirder.
I know what you want. Oh, sure, they may have tried to separate us, but what we have is too strong, it's too powerful. I mean, after all, we shared everything, you and I. I told you my deepest, darkest secrets. I showed you exactly what people are capable of. I shocked you with my honesty, but mostly I challenged you and made you think. And you trusted me, even though you knew you shouldn't. So we're not done, no matter what anyone says. And besides, I know what you want. You want me back.
There's interesting stuff going on in there if, or would be if this wasn't such a serious issue.
Yeah.
Because he's taking a character that everybody knows him by, and then he's sort of playing around with reality and what's going on in the TV show. Because I watched the whole of House of Cards. I watched the last season just recently, and I thought it, although it had been sort of getting a bit old already, I thought that the last season was weaker because Spacey wasn't in it. And it was really awkwardly done. It had to be awkwardly done that he just suddenly disappears altogether, when in the last season he was still very much, you know, a part of the game. But yeah, it's an interesting thing, I think, that he's trying to sort of... I understand where he's coming from, because he seems to be a kind of guy who's a really coldly calculating on how he's trying to wriggle away from this whole situation.
Yeah, the only problem is that he's not really good at calculus. I mean,
yeah.
In a way.
yeah, it's true. But in his mind, I think that the first time when he did that coming out thing right after, he actually thought that this is a good move.
Yeah.
I mean, this is a strategically good move to get people's attention away from the fact that he's probably a rapist.
Yeah.
That he's actually gay and he has these problems because he's gay. And now he's taking that even further. And I think it's really interesting in terms of how what celebrity does to people. Because it seems that he's done this video sort of in earnest. Like you said, he's not very good at calculus, but I think he really thinks he is.
Yeah.
And this kind of being so far out there in terms of thinking that this isn't creepy or this isn't weird or this whole rhetoric is somehow going to make people appreciate him more. I don't think that he wants people to like him necessarily because his character is so unappealing. But I think that he wants them to acknowledge that
he's too damn good to be.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like ushered into the dark.
Yeah. And that's, that takes a lot of balls.
It does.
I mean, or it takes a lot of, you know, the other thing is that either it takes a lot of balls or then it's just that you're venturing into that Michael Jackson cuckoo land.
Yeah.
That you don't really realize that what the things that you've done or allegedly have done have damaged people.
Yeah.
And because with with Spacey, at first it was Anthony Rapp, who accused him of rape or, you know, sleeping with a minor when he was like 16 years of age. And since then, there's been more and more people, like with the Cosby thing.
Yeah.
And there's more and more people now coming out saying that he was constantly behaving unprofessionally and harassing young men.
Yeah.
On apparently most of his movies or a lot of his movies that in a lot of his movies he's been by some people in the cast or crew they felt uncomfortable by the way that he's acted.
But
if you haven't seen this video, I think you should really see it because it's a really fascinating insight into what happens in somebody's mind when they get sort of cornered.
Yeah.
And they don't know what to do anymore. No. And they have to somehow try to salvage.
I hope he makes more. I'm sorry, but it's just the weirdest form of entertainment available to man.
Yeah.
It's just so... I mean, how many views has it gotten? Something like, is it 10 million or 15 million? I mean, it's so weird and creepy. And
he's probably looking at home. Yes, I got 15 million views. This probably means good things.
but apparently, apparently has no one to tell him, like, listen, Kevin.
it's time to lay low.
No, just like, let the court proceedings take their course and then we can try to do something. But this is just... Yeah. Fucking creepy dude.
it's weird because with some people, like with Jackson, by the end I was sort of off Jackson because he was so far out there. But in a way, I was thinking about Michael Jackson the other day when I started thinking about people who sort of... Because we eventually, at some point, we become cynical and we lose some of the things that we were capable of doing when we were children. Yeah. And... You can say anything about Michael Jackson, but that was probably one of the things that he actually didn't lose.
Mm.
That he really wanted to stay a child and be able to look at the world through a child's eyes, through some other child's eyes as well. But anyway, with Spacey, I find it's so hard to feel sorry for him.
Yeah.
It's so hard to feel sorry for him because he's arrogantly digging his own grave.
Well, he is basically doing that, yeah.
Yeah.
But he is, the dude is a genius at acting.
And yeah,
I think
I've read
some stories and heard some stories about his childhood and shit like that. And he seems like in kitchen psychology terms, a proper sociopath, basically.
Yeah. Yeah.
Something like that.
This gas can, this red gas can from his truck. And he looks at me one last time. And he lights a match. And the last thing I remember, and I'll never forget it, were his eyes. His eyes, because they were filled with this immense satisfaction. Yeah. Don't tell me how sorry you are for me.
I agree that he was, or is, he still is a wonderful, wonderful actor. Yeah. And there are some movies that I simply will not. I won't agree to not see them.
Yeah.
Because of Kevin Spacey, he's done magnificent work, and I thought that the first couple of seasons of House of Cards were really, really good as well.
Yeah.
Before it started to go get too repetitive. Mm,
yeah.
But he was made. I understand also why he chose to do it this way, because he was born to play that role. Mm. He's so good in that role, and then. Unfortunately, it seems that he's a bit like that in real life as well.
Yeah, and he probably just doesn't. Maybe he just doesn't know how to make an earnest video,
yeah,
where he's talking about this issue that is going on.
Yeah, I think it's got a lot to do with just not being able to see the line anymore.
Yeah, and I think he might have in his mind just sort of an image of a. But those boys, they were lucky to be touched by a genius like me. Or something like that. I mean, might be such an amount of hybris there going on that he's going off the rails.
Yeah, and he was very successful, and he was successful in a lot of things. I mean, not only as a film actor, but as... Because I think he was, I understood that he was quite revered when he took over the old big theater in London, and he made a good run of it, and so on. So there was a lot of good stuff going on in his life. But it's weird too, because, I mean, in the beginning of his career, I understand why he was a closet homosexual. Mm. But, I mean, he could have come out like, 10 years ago and nobody would have cared.
Yeah.
Everybody knew anyway, and he would have gotten exactly the same roles probably that he got today. So, but again, hard to feel sorry for the guy.
It is.
He does stuff like this.